Hi everyone, hope your NEET preparation is going in full swing. Today we will discuss the first year chapter Structural Organization in Animals. So in this chapter we will mainly go through the different types of tissues like epithelial tissue, connective tissue, then muscular tissue, neural tissue, and also we will discuss about Periplaneta americana. Periplaneta americana, which is our cockroach, its morphology as well as its anatomy. So we have a set of questions for you, starting with the first one here. Select the true statements. So in this question, we discuss the classification of epithelial tissue. So for that, you should know the correct classification shown here. Epithelial tissue is classified into simple as well as compound. Simple epithelium, it is a single layered epithelium. Only one layer of cells you can see in simple epithelium. Whereas in compound epithelium, you can see it is multi-layered. Different layers of cells you can see. And simple epithelium, it is further classified. How it is classified? It is classified into squamous, then cuboidal, columnar, and also ciliated. I repeat, squamous, cuboidal, columnar, and ciliated. Based on the shape of the cell and also based on the location and function, we can see this classification. Mainly based on the nature of the cells, right? So all these points you should keep in your mind when you answer this questions from epithelial tissue. And also for compound epithelium, we have stratified squamous and also stratified cuboidal. Stratified tissue is always multi-layered. You can see more layers of cells here, and which is the uppermost layer of cells, based on that we will name that particular tissue. So in the case of stratified squamous epithelium, the superficial layer of cells will be made up of squamous epithelium. And in the case of stratified cuboidal, the superficial layer of cells will be made up of cubical cells or cuboidal cells. Stratified squamous epithelium is further classified into keratinized and non-keratinized. Whereas stratified cuboidal epithelium, you can see it here in the case of large ducks. So remember, the stratified keratinized epithelium is mainly found in skin, hair, horn, nail, etc. And stratified non-keratinized, that means there is no keratin. Stratified non-keratinized epithelium, it is mainly found in the esophagus, pharynx, vaginal region, etc. So this classification of epithelial tissue is very important. You should know the location and also you should have a clear idea about it, the function of each and every type of epithelial tissue. Here we have the another slide here. This slide is about the different types of glands based on the mode of their secretion. We have holocrine, mirocrine, and apocrine. These are the three types of glands based on their mode of secretion. In the case of holocrine glands, you can see the cell will burst during the discharge of secretion. The cell is getting destroyed during discharge of secretion. For example, in the case of sebaceous glands, the cell is getting destroyed when discharge happens. But in the case of mirocrine glands, there is no loss for the cell. There is no loss for the cell. And here, by simple exocytosis, the discharge or the secretion will happen. So that is in the case of mirocrine glands. It is applicable for glands of producing digestive enzymes, mainly that of the gastrointestinal tract. Then in apocrine, in the case of apocrine gland, only the apical portion of the cell will be lost. For example, in the case of mammary glands, only the apical portion of the cell will be lost during discharge of secretion. So here, mammary glands are examples for apocrine. So glands are classified based on mode of secretion into holocrine, mirocrine, and apocrine. So coming back to our question, we have the question here, select the true statements. In columnar epithelium, nuclei are located at the base. That is a correct statement. Ciliated cuboidal epithelium is found in fallopian tube. Of course, it will help in movement of the ovum. Then glands that secrete mucus, serum and oil and milk, they are holocrine. That is a wrong statement, because your oil secreting sebaceous glands are holocrine, but others are belonging to the other two categories, neurocrine and apocrine. Milk secreting will be apocrine, but other glands are usually neurocrine. Then third statement is wrong here. What about the fourth one? Transitional epithelium will lack the basement membrane. That is a correct statement, because transitional epithelium is a type of compound epithelium, and in transitional epithelium, which is located in urinary bladder, basement membrane is absent. What about the fifth one? Cornified epithelium is found in hoof and nail. Cornified means keratinized. So the keratinized epithelium is found in hoof and nail. So that is also a correct statement. So our answer will be option A here. Right. We move on to our next question. We have two types of connective tissues shown here in diagram A and diagram B. So this diagram, this A diagram, it is that of tendon. Here the fibers are arranged in a regular manner. So that corresponds to tendon. And this diagram B corresponds to the dense connective tissue, which is irregular in nature, irregular type of dense connective tissue. You should have a clear idea about the classification of connective tissues. For that, we have another slide here. Here, in this slide, the connective tissue is classified into loose, you can see here, loose connective tissue, then dense connective tissue, and finally, you can see the specialized connective tissue. How they are classified? Loose connective tissue is classified into areolar and adipose tissue. Loose connective tissue is classified into areolar and adipose. Whereas the dense connective tissue, it is classified into regular and irregular. Based on the arrangement of fibers, we can classify in this manner, regular and irregular. And regular connective tissue is further classified into tendon and ligament. Okay, two examples are the tendon and ligament. Tendon will connect skeletal muscle with the bone, and ligament will connect bone to bone. Bone to bone connection is by ligament. And irregular kind of dense connective tissue, example is white fibrous tissue. You can see it in the skull bone sutures. And what about the specialized type of connective tissue? Specialized connective tissue, here bone, cartilage, blood. These are the three examples for specialized type of connective tissue. Okay, we move on to the question now. We have the question. Two types of tissues are represented below. Which of the following statement is false? A and B are dense connective tissues. It is a correct statement. Then B has fibroblast and many fibers, mostly collagen. They are oriented differently. That is a correct statement. Then B connects bone to bone. That is wrong, because this B diagram is not that of ligament. So only the ligament is connecting bone to bone. This is white fibrous tissue or irregular type of dense connective tissue. So this statement C is wrong. What about option D? That is correct, because tendon, it will connect skeletal muscle with a bone. So that is a correct statement. So we move on to our next question here. Which is our next question? Adipose tissue is not characterized by. Adipose tissue is the type of loose connective tissue. Okay, so we have the diagram of adipose tissue here, and the explanation is given. Adipose tissue is another type of loose connective tissue. It is located mainly beneath the skin. The cells of this tissue are specialized to store fat. And the excess of nutrients which are not used immediately are converted into fats and are stored in this tissue. So this is the explanation for adipose tissue directly taken from your NCERT textbook. Here we have the picture of adipose tissue with adipocytes. Adipocytes, what is their function? They will do the storage of fat. So it's very clear about adipose tissue. We have the question now. We can answer this question very easily. Our answer will be option D. All the statements A, B and C applicable for adipose tissue. But only this option D, it is that of ligament. So our answer is option D here. Is it clear? Shall we move to our next question? Yes, we have the question about areolar tissue now. Areolar tissue is characterized by What you learn about areolar tissue is that it is found beneath the skin. We have the slide of areolar tissue shown here. It is found beneath the skin, and it is a help. It is the main type of tissue among connective tissues. It is the most abundant type of connective tissue. It is mainly the packing type of connective tissue, and labeling is very important. Macrophage, fibroblast, collagen fibers are labeled here. So you should identify the each and every part here. Okay, mast cells. You should know also the function of mast cells very well. Okay, mast cells, what is their function in areolar tissue? Sometimes they will ask. So coming back to our question, areolar tissue is characterized by, it is characterized by fibroblast, macrophages and mast cells. So our answer will be option A. What about other options? Collagen fibers are present in rows between many parallel bundles. This is applicable for tendon. This option B is applicable for tendon. What about option C? This is for bone. This is for bone. Osteocytes present in the spaces called lacunae. That is applicable for bone. What about adipocytes storing droplets? That is for adipose tissue. So you have the answer, option A. Very good. We will move on to our next question. Again, this question is about areolar tissue. In areolar tissue, you have to find out the incorrectly labeled parts. You have to find out the incorrect labeling. So here, very easy. I will give you some time. Can you identify the incorrectly labeled parts? I will give you some time. Okay. 10-15 seconds. Is it okay? Yes. Some of you are answering it correctly. Yes. Macrophage and fibroblast. That is your answer? I don't think so. Macrophage is correctly labeled here. It will be mast cell and fibroblast wrongly matched here. We will move to the answer here. Next slide. The answer slide here. Mast cell and fibroblast. These two parts are incorrectly labeled. Okay. So this kind of questions will appear. You have to identify the incorrect labeling. Okay. Sometimes you will have to identify the correct labeling. Sometimes the incorrect labeling. Okay, now we move on to the next question. Here, this is a question about the sexual dimorphism in cockroach. In the case of cockroach, how you can identify the male cockroach and female cockroach? The male cockroach will have a pair of anal styles arising from the 9th segment. You can see the anal styles here. These are the anal styles in male cockroach. Remember, this is a male cockroach. Only the male cockroach will have anal styles, anal cerci, these broad structures that is applicable for both. Anal cerci, they arise from the 10th segment and it is applicable for both male cockroach and female cockroach. Whereas anal styles, they are applicable only for the male cockroach and it will arise from the 9th sternum. It will arise from the 9th sternum. So that is the main difference between male cockroach and female cockroach. As science students, at least you should know the difference between male cockroach and female cockroach. Once you identify the anal styles in one cockroach, once you see that, you can say that it is a male one. Okay, it's applicable for male. So which is our correct answer here? Our answer is option D. Some of you are answering it correctly. A is male, X is anal cerci, Y is anal style, and B, female, and females are having anal cerci. I request everyone to answer questions right at the time when I show these questions to you. Okay, not when the answer is shown. Before that you can answer. Okay, when I do the explanation. Okay, very good. We move on to our next question. Regarding Periplaneta americana, select the correct statements. So, Periplaneta americana, what are its features? You know it very well. It is porometabolous. The development of Periplaneta americana is porometabolous, or it is a gradual kind of metamorphosis happening in Periplaneta americana, in cockroaches. Gradual metamorphosis. There will be 13 times the molting will happen. The shedding of exoskeleton will happen 13 times. So gradually the nymph is transforming into an adult. In the case of cockroach. So, among statements before answering, let me show you one slide. Let me show you one slide. This is the picture of a cockroach. So in this cockroach, you can see the mesothoracic legs, metathoracic legs. Hey, very clear. Pronotum, compound eyes are the dentemina, hind wing. Okay, only the hind wings are used for flight. Tegmina, you know, they are not used for flight in cockroach. Okay, so this diagram is enough. We will move to the question. So here, all the statements are true regarding Periplaneta americana. In males, the genital pouch or genital chamber lies at the hind end of the abdomen, bounded dorsally by the 9th and 10th tulga and ventrally by the 9th sternum. Second statement is also true. Female produces 9 to 10 utike, each containing 14 to 16 eggs in them. Then fourth one, in females, the 7th sternum is boat shaped and it will overlap the 8th and 9th sterna, and that will form the brood pouch in cockroach. So all the statements are true here. So our answer is option D. Okay. So remember, all these sentences, they are taken directly from your NCERT textbook. So you should have a clear idea about this concept. And also, sometimes they will change the position. Okay. Here, you should by heart 9th and 10th tulga. Okay. Dorsal. So dorsal, ventral, these terms, they can change and they can confuse you. Okay, so the reading of NCERT is compulsory, and you should read each and every sentence. Okay, next question. We have the next question again about Periplaneta americana. It is about the spiracles and also about the Malpighian tubules. You know what are spiracles? It is part of their tracheal system. It will help in their respiration. They are the external openings in Periplaneta americana, helping for taking air. Then Malpighian tubules, they are excretory in function. We have the slide for you. The slide will show you the spiracles and Malpighian tubules. Here, you can see the spiracles. 10 pairs of spiracles are present in cockroach. 2 pairs are in the thorax and 8 pairs are in the abdomen. Okay, prothorax do not have spiracles. Only the mesothorax and metathorax region, they have spiracles. So, 8 pairs in the abdomen, because abdominal region is having 8 segments. So, here you can see the Malpighian tubules. There will be 150 tiny Malpighian tubules applicable for cockroach. Okay, Malpighian tubules are helping for excretion in them. So, coming back to our question. We have the question here regarding Periplaneta americana. You have to identify the correct statements. Actually, all the statements are true. They have 10 pairs of spiracles on the lateral side of the body. They have Malpighian tubules which will remove the nitrogenous waste from the coelomic fluid. They have fat body, nephrocytes and uricose glands which are accessory excretory organs in them, which is the primary excretory organ in cockroach. The primary excretory organ in cockroach will be Malpighian tubules. But in addition to Malpighian tubules, these fat body, nephrocytes and uricose glands will help also help in excretion. So we'll move to our next question. In cockroach, wings originate from. So we have a diagram of cockroach showing its wing pattern. Okay. How many wings are there? There are 2 pairs of wings. The first pair of wings are fore wings. Second pair of wings are called hind wings. So this is the first pair of wings. First pair of wings are very dark. Okay. They are opaque. They are leathery. And that is called tegmina. The first pair of wings are called tegmina. And they are not used for flight. These are mesothoracic wings. From the first thoracic segment, you cannot see wings. Prothorax do not have wings. Only the mesothorax and metathorax will have wings. And this is the hind wings. A pair of hind wings you can see in them. Hind wings are second pair of wings. And they are used for flight. They are transparent. So the second pair of wings, they arise from the third thoracic segment. First pair of wings arise from the second thoracic segment. Remember, I repeat, the first pair of wings arise from the second thoracic segment, and the third pair of wings will arise from the third thoracic segment. You got it? So we move on to the question once again. In cockroach, wings originate from the first thoracic segments and second thoracic segment. That is wrong. First abdominal segments, no, never from abdomen. Okay, second and third thoracic segment, that is true. So from the second and third thoracic segments, the first and second pair of wings will arise. You got it? So answer is option C. Other options are only for confusion. Okay, the last option, the first thoracic segment, remember, from prothorax, I repeat, no wings arise from the first thoracic segment. And what about the legs? Legs will arise from all the three thoracic segments. Now, next question for you. We have the next question. Accessory sex gland found in male cockroach helping for nourishment of the sperms. So, this question is about the accessory sex glands. And you should have a clear idea about the reproductive system, the male reproductive system and female reproductive system in the case of cockroach. We have the slide for you. So here we have the slide. This is for male and this is for female. In the case of male cockroach, what are the accessory sex glands you can see? You can see a mushroom shaped gland over here. Okay. So this is a mushroom shaped gland, which is also called the utricular gland. And it mainly helps in providing nourishment to the sperms. Mushroom shaped gland will help in providing nourishment to the sperms. Whereas the phallic gland shown here, this phallic gland or conglobate gland, it is otherwise called conglobate gland. It will help in producing a secretion which will glue the sperms. And in the case of female cockroach, they have a pair of collateral glands. Female cockroach is having a pair of collateral glands which will help in producing utica. So we have the question for you. So you should have a clear idea about the reproductive system. Question. We have the question slide for you. Yes, here it is. The accessory sex gland found in male cockroach helping for nourishment of the sperms. So here you have to fill the utricular gland or mushroom shaped gland for this first option. For the second option, sperm stored in seminal vesicles and are glued together to form bundles called spermatophores by secretion from the phallic gland. Phallic gland is also called the conglobate gland. So our answer for the second statement will be phallic gland. Okay. So answer option C. It's very easy. Okay. I'm not repeating all the options. So you can take a screenshot if you if necessary. When you feel that I'm going very fast, sometimes, you can take a screenshot of that particular slide so that you can go through the options slowly. Right. Here we have the next question. Select the correct match for periplaneta. For periplaneta, a pair of testes will be located not in the, you have to find out the correct match. This is actually wrongly matched. The second and sixth abdominal segments, there you can see ovaries for the female cockroach. So this is wrong. Actually, in fourth, fifth, sixth abdominal segments, you can see a pair of testes. So this is wrongly matched. The second and the third, they are correctly matched because in nymphal stage, it will mount 13 times and utica, 9 to 10 utica will be there and each utica will contain 14 to 16 eggs. A cockroach will produce 9 to 10 utica in its lifetime and each utica will have 14 to 16 eggs in it. So the second and third, they are true. Ovaries wrongly matched because you have to match it here. Okay. Now, a pair of spermatheca, that is correctly matched. No, it is not correctly matched. Actually, not in thoracic segment, you can see the spermatheca. Spermatheca, they are present in the abdominal segment. Okay. Not in the thoracic segment. Sixth abdominal segment and it opens into the genital chamber. So here, this is also wrongly matched. Okay. So correctly matched will be 2 and 3. Coming to our answer. Next slide. Before that, you can see here the picture of utica. Okay. Cockroach producing utica here. You can see it very clearly. And this is the life cycle of cockroach. An adult cockroach producing utica. From utica, a nymphal stage is produced here. So it is undergoing development like this. Okay. After several molts, after 13 molts, it will become the adult. You got it? So utica, our answer here will be option D. Very clear. We move on to our next question. Identify the labial parts in the alimentary canal of cockroach in the sequence A, B, C, D. It's a very simple question, because for your practicals, you are familiar with this diagram. Crop practicals, especially for the state syllabus students, not for the CBSE students. They are familiar, state syllabus students, they are familiar with this diagram at least, because they have to draw this diagram in the records. So here, labeled as A will be crop, B will be hepatic CK, C malpighian tubules, and D will be the rectum. So here the hindgut portion is having ileum, colon, and rectum. We have the next slide here. The next slide will show you in detail the structure of the alimentary canal of cockroach. So here, remember, the hindgut is having ileum, colon, and the last portion is rectum. So coming back to our question. So here, the correctly matched will be option B. Crop, hepatic CK, malpighian tubules, okay, and rectum. Rectum is not that much correct. If it is a colon, it will be correct. Okay, so here there is a slight correction. You should read it as colon, right? You should read it as colon, because part labeled as D is colon. Okay, so when you correct this, our answer will become B. So we move on to our next question. We have the question of mouth parts. Labium, that is the lower lip, labrum is the upper lip. Then we have a pair of mandibles, a pair of maxillae, a pair of hypopharynx is single. Okay, all others are actually maxilla, mandibles are paired, but hypopharynx is single. We will move to the slide. So mouth parts in cockroach, they are biting and chewing type. Biting and chewing type of mouth parts in cockroach, they are labrum, labium, hypopharynx. Okay, these three are single. These three are single. Mandibles and maxilla, they are paired in nature. Remember, in cockroach, biting and chewing type of mouth parts are present. We move to the question here. When you answer the question, our answer will be option A. Okay, so labrum is labeled as R here. Then mandible will be marked as P here. You can see P there. Okay, then hypopharynx will be marked as S here. So we can answer that question very easily. So our session finishes right now. We will be back with another set of questions next time. Until then, it's goodbye from Stephen Classes. Next class, we will discuss a chapter from second year. Okay, always it will be like that. One day first year, another day second year. So tomorrow we will have discussion from the second year chapter. We will discuss the health and disease chapter, right? So be prepared with the health and diseases. Until then, it's goodbye from Stephen Classes.